De niet-residerende ambassadeur van Ghana, Abena Pokua Odempem Bosia, heeft een beleefdheidsbezoek gebracht aan president Chandrika Prasad Santokhi. Dit gebeurde op donderdag 26 november 2020.
It was a courtesy call, you know. I have not been here since he was elected because I'm based in Brasilia. I'm a non-resident ambassador. And I was actually in Ghana. But Suriname is very, very important to Ghana. The relations between Ghana and Suriname are important. So my president sent me back from Ghana as a special envoy to take part in the 45th anniversary celebrations and to bring a message of greeting to the president. So that's why I was, you know, to reassure Suriname of our continued friendship and engagement. It was a simple message. It was a wonderful experience. You know, I was just sharing with the president, I am African, I'm Ghanaian. And so I am, of course, very proud of how very deeply rooted in Ghanaian culture the African side of Suriname is. But on an occasion like we saw yesterday, it was so special and moving to see in the National Assembly the way you always manage to celebrate the diversity of your cultures and to give us ceremonies where you can see the distinction, the indigenous, the South Asian, and the African, and yet they form a creative whole. The invocation that started that open parliament, for example, was so moving. And it's something you're justifiably proud of. And I was just sharing that one of the things I would like to do is to help explore the African aspects so that in Suriname you understand a little better the origins in Ghana, and in Ghana we learn how they have survived in Suriname so we can have a conversation across the waters and come to a deeper understanding of who we are as one people. You know, I'm a teacher at heart. Oh, there are many ways. There are many ways. We can, you know, it takes an act of will. We have to want to do it. Once we want to do it, we can do things like share curriculum, develop curriculum together. We can promote tourism, but make sure it's heritage tourism. You know, tourism, you can come and have a lot of fun, but there's a way of promoting tourism that also raises consciousness, raises the level. I was just saying, for example, I'm based in Brazil, and the national foods of Brazil, acarajé and feijoada, they are both African roots. But how many Brazilian people know that? How many Brazilian people know that these foods survived because they were sacred to African gods? It won't take long, won't take much for the tourist industry to add that aspect of understanding to what they do. So we can do that. Well, you know, yesterday in Parliament, the person doing the invocation had white clay on her. Why? You know, that is the sign of ancestral spirits all over West Africa. So when you find it in Suriname, we can teach the children, this is why we do it. It's not arbitrary. It has its roots somewhere else. So there are I always believe as an educator in beginning with what we know. So begin with what we eat, how we dress, and talk about where does the material come from, where does the cloth come from, why these particular ingredients. Then you have the familiar, which then becomes part of a bigger vision, a bigger world. You know, there are many ways to begin. Yes, we actually have memorandum of understanding, We need to work with them. That's one of the reasons I'm here. We want to do more programs. But yes, there's an educational memorandum of understanding, for example, between Anton de Kom and one of our major universities of science and technology. There's a memorandum of understanding on education and culture. The question is now to take those memorandums and develop the programs. But we have a lot of memoranda with Suriname. And one of the things I'm keen on is, for example, there's an air services one, but we need to encourage our business people to do airlines, because right now, if you want to come to Ghana from Suriname, you have to go to Amsterdam and then fly from Amsterdam to Accra. So you have 9 hours, a 4-hour wait and a 9-hour journey for what is a 6-hour journey. If you could fly straight from Paramaribo to Accra, 6 hours, you know. So we're discussing things like that. Things take long. So some things could probably happen more quickly than others. We could probably have conversations about tourism and educational exchanges faster than we can get the airlines, because for something like the airlines, it's a major investment and you need a partnership that believes that it could work and is prepared to take the risk, etc., and needs to be persuaded, or else they want you to create the volume first. Something like an airline, although we are frustrated that it doesn't exist, it's a major, major investment. So things will happen anything from a few months to a few years, depending on what. But you need to be patient. If it's important, you need to be patient.